What is disability art? It is art that expresses my experience of life as a disabled person and my interpretation of other people's experiences. Not in a vicarious way, but in an understanding, empathetic way. So I got into disability arts, and I really got it. I really got the sense that this was art about real stuff in life. And so I related to disability art immediately. We, within disability arts, see it as a driver, almost as a life force, really. The rest of the world just doesn't even know it's there, does it? I never quite understand why people don't get disability art. You know, you look back at great paintings, Picasso, Toulouse-Lautrec, Degas. They painted what was there. They painted the people and the places that they hung out in, and it was contemporary. What was happening right there, right then. I think that's what disability art does. It engages with what's happening right here and right now, and what it is that creates barriers for us as disabled people. There was such a hunger for people, for disabled people particularly, to see their own stories or the experiences they were having, or an artistic take on it. And they just wanted to, loved being together and talking, you know, talking and different perspectives. And we experienced that everywhere we went. Why do we go to theatre and expect not to sit next to a learning disabled person? Why are people with conditions like Tourette's having to make shows to occupy space on stage, or to have to actively advocate for their inclusion in these spaces? But there was always that disconnection with mental health, in that the political heart of the survivor movement was very much about challenging the sense of mental illness existing at all, challenging the fact of impairment. Whereas disability arts was very much about accepting impairment and challenging the barriers that society places in front of the individual for being different, for having a different body to what is seen as the norm. I reconciled that disconnect to myself through seeing how disabling the treatments that psychiatry dishes out are, and how people under mental health are disabled by attitudes from professionals right down to their reception from everyday people. To get work as disability art, it's not always easy because our ideas are so forward-thinking. It doesn't fit in to the medical rules of people, whether they know that or not, are used to. I got this piece and it was funded by the Arts Council, but because nobody knew who I was, I couldn't tour it. We don't want some disabled bloke coming in and telling us things that we don't want to hear, and neither do our audience. I know someone recently who got a real lot of money to make a piece of work. And basically, it was about her pain and suffering. And that's what they like to commission. Why is there an expectation that the work of disabled people has to be 100% perfect? It's got to hit many more targets in terms of quality than anyone else. A lot of art is about the right to fail, and many artists are allowed to fail. But when it comes to disability or other groups within diversity, sorry, you've got to hit those heady heights or your validity is called into question. One of the things that frustrates me is that companies say that not all directors are into doing relaxed performance. Well, you get to make the work you do, but you don't get to say who gets to see it. If you're not prepared to do relaxed performance, then list who you don't want in your audience. Tell me who you don't want. What I like to do is make work that really doesn't embrace disability, in the way of saying, aren't we fantastic and aren't we great? And by showing this work, more and more of us are all going to become empowered, and just by watching it, you're going to understand our lives better, and really, that we'll become equal. It's just bullshit. Absolute bullshit.